Books on Tape presents Queen Bees and Wannabes, helping your daughter survive cliques, gossip, boyfriends, and other realities of adolescence, by Rosalind Wiseman. Read by Lee Adams. Introduction. My daughter used to be so wonderful. Now I can barely stand her, and she won't tell me anything. I feel totally shut out. How can I find out what's going on? There's a clique in my daughter's grade that's making her life miserable. She doesn't want to go to school anymore. Her own supposed friends are turning on her, and she's too afraid to do anything. What can I do? My daughter has perfect skin and a beautiful body, yet she complains constantly that she has acne and is too fat. I raised her to feel good about herself, and she's breaking my heart. What should I do? My daughter is 11, and she wants to shave her legs. She follows me around the house begging me. I think it's totally inappropriate, but she won't stop talking about it. How do I make her realize she's too young? My daughter printed out an email from her boyfriend and left it on the mail table. It was horribly abusive. Did she leave it out on purpose for me to see? What should I do? Welcome to the wonderful world of your daughter's adolescence. 10 seconds ago, she was a sweet, confident, world-beating little girl who looked up to you. Now she's changing before your very eyes. She's confused, insecure, often surly, lashing out. On a good day, she's teary and threatening to run away. On a bad day, you're ready to help her pack her suitcase. She's facing the toughest pressures of adolescent life, test driving her new body, figuring out the social world, toughing it out in school. And intuitively, you know that even though she's sometimes totally obnoxious, she needs you more than ever. Yet, it's the very time when she's pulling away from you. Why do teenage and preteen girls so often reject their parents and turn to their girlfriends instead, even when those friends often treat them so cruelly? Every girl I know has been hurt by her girlfriends. One day, your daughter comes to school and her friends suddenly decide she no longer belongs. Or she's teased mercilessly for wearing the wrong outfit or having the wrong friend. Maybe she's branded with a reputation she can't shake. Or trapped, feeling she has to conform to what her friends expect from her so she won't be kicked out of the group. No matter what they do to her, she still feels that her friends know her best and want what is best for her. In comparison, she believes that you, previously a reliable source of information, don't have a clue. For parents, being rejected by your daughter is an excruciating experience, especially when you're immediately replaced by a group of girls with all the tact, sense of fairness, and social graces of a pack of marauding hyenas. Whatever you feel as your daughter goes through this process, you can be sure that she'll go through her share of humiliating experiences and constant insecurity. That's normal for teens. Most people believe a girl's task is to get through it, grow up, and put those experiences behind her. But your daughter's relationships with other girls have much deeper and farther-reaching implications beyond her turbulent teen years. Your daughter's friendships with other girls are a double-edged sword. They're key to surviving adolescence, yet they can be the biggest threat to her survival as well. The friendships with the girls in her clique are a template for many relationships she'll have as an adult. Many girls will make it through their teen years precisely because they have the support and care of a few good friends. These are the friendships where a girl truly feels unconditionally accepted and understood, and they can last into adulthood and support her search for adult relationships. On the other hand, girls can be each other's worst enemies. Girls' friendships in adolescence are often intense, confusing, frustrating, and humiliating. The joy and security of best friends shattered by devastating breakups and betrayals. Girls' reactions to the ups and downs of these friendships are as intense as they'll later feel in intimate relationships. These early relationships can propel girls into making dangerous decisions and shape how they mature into young women. But your daughter is too close to it all to realize the good and bad influence of her friends. She needs guidance from you. This book will examine cliques, reputations, gossiping, rebellion, bullying, crushes, and boyfriends. It will show you how your daughter is conditioned to remain silent when intimidated by more powerful girls, and the lessons she learns from this experience. It will teach you how to recognize which friends will support her and which could lead her towards situations that threaten her emotional health and sometimes even her physical safety. It'll show you how your daughter's place in her social pecking order can affect whether she'll be a perpetrator, bystander, or victim of violence when she's older. This book will also reveal how these dynamics contribute to the disconnection and struggle between the two of you. I'll also describe and explain the key rites of passage your daughter is likely to experience, getting an invitation to an exclusive party in sixth grade, or getting left off the guest list, her first breakup with a friend, the first time she dresses up for a party in the latest style, and so on. These are all critical milestones for her, but they're rites of passage for you, too. Just as they can be exhilarating or traumatizing for her, they can be equally challenging for you as her parent, and not just in terms of the extent to which they try your patience. Mishandling them can threaten your relationship with her. I'll help you navigate them together. Moreover, this book will show you how constantly changing cultural ideals of femininity impact your daughter's self-esteem, friendships, and social status, and can combine to make her more likely to have sex at an early age and be vulnerable to violence at the hands of some men and boys. It will also explain what you can do to help your daughter avoid these pitfalls. Understanding your teen or preteen daughter's friendships and social life can be difficult and frustrating. Parents often tell me they feel totally shut out from this part of their daughter's life, incapable of exerting any influence. This book will let you in. It'll show you how to help your daughter deal with the nasty things girls do to one another and minimize the negative effects of what's often an invisible war behind girls' friendships. Before I go any further, let me reassure you that I can help you even if you often feel that you're at war with your daughter. It's perfectly natural at this stage that she stops looking to you for answers, doesn't respect your opinion as much as she did before, believes that there's no possible way that you could understand what she's going through, lies and sneaks behind your back, denies she's lied and went behind your back, even in the face of undeniable evidence. On the other hand, it's natural that you feel rejected when she rolls her eyes at everything you say, have moments when you really don't like her. Wonder whose child this is anyway, because this person in front of you can't possibly be your sweet, wonderful daughter. Feel confused when conversations end in fights. Feel misunderstood when she feels you're intruding and prying when you ask what's going on in her life. Are really worried about the influence of her friends and feel powerless to stop her hanging out with them, because of course she'll keep the friends you don't like if you expressly forbid her from seeing them. The mother-daughter maelstrom. Moms and daughters seem to have the hardest time with each other during girls' adolescence. Your daughter craves privacy, and you directly threaten her sense of privacy. You feel you have so much to offer her. After all, you've been through the changes she's experiencing, and you think your advice will help. Think of your daughter as a beaver. She's constantly cutting down logs, branches, twigs, anything she can find, dragging them to her den, trying to create a safe haven from the outside world. In her eyes, you're always stomping on it, asking why the logs are there in the first place when you have this nice one that would look so pretty, rearranging the branches, hovering around the entranceway, yelling your suggestions and saying that it would look much better if it was just a little more organized. You're not just totally disturbing her peace, you're storming her sacred retreat. While this privacy war is natural, it creates a big problem. Girls are often so focused on resisting the influence of their parents that they rarely see when their peers are influencing them in the wrong way. Teens often see things in very concrete, either-or ways. You, as the parent, are intrusive and prying, which equals bad. Her peers are involved and understanding, which equals good. She pushes you away, making even more space for the bad influences. Fathers feel it too. This book isn't only for mothers. Fathers also have struggles with the child who just moments ago was daddy's little girl. Still, there are many ways your unique perspective can help your daughter. Just because you were never a girl doesn't mean you can't.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.